October 29th, Stephen Campbell will be in uniform with the L.A. Palma Cyclones as they take on the Arizona Arsenal. That'll be a great game. Following that immediately is the retirement of Joe Cook's jersey. We want to thank Stephen Campbell for spending a couple minutes with us to talk about Alkali Hockey, and we look forward to seeing their products hitting the market soon. We'll be right back on the RollerHockeyTV.net network after these commercial messages. We're live here in Cincinnati, Ohio, the Sphere, and I'm with the man who's made this all happen, the president and founder of State Wars Hockey, Mr. Tim McManus. First of all, Tim, thank you so much for being able to spend some time with us today.
Thank you, Doug. It's my pleasure.
One of the greatest things, and people don't know this, Tim, how'd you come up with the concept for State Wars originally?
Well, you know, we just go to a lot of tournaments, see how much the kids love to play the game, how much pride they have in where they come from, and we just wanted to create an event where players can represent their state and eventually now their province. You know, instead of just jumping ship and playing with teams all around the country, we want to keep it organized within the state, state pride, not be about who can recruit the best players, but who can coach and teach players at home, and then go to single berth years and make the games more competitive. You know, why play up against older kids when you can play against your own berth year every single time and always be on your on year?
I think you've made some great moves. I mean, allowing the provinces in Canada to be able to play. And if you've been a part of State Wars and you've been here, it's an amazing time for your child. Not only do the kids have the opportunity to trade jerseys and their state pins, which they proudly display, but the camaraderie that goes on here. I've been watching games, and I was fortunate enough to be a state director. It is an amazing experience. And, Tim, what's the magic that goes on behind that?
Well, it's a lot of work. You know, people always say, is this the only thing you do? You know, for the last 4 months, it's, you know, 60, 70 hours a week just preparing for this event. You know, making sure every player's uniform, their name is right, their number is correct. You know, getting the rosters together. We lock the rosters for the tournament. You know, we know every player in this event. You know, players don't play on multiple teams. It's truly unique teams. You know, 2,500 players playing. And it definitely a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff goes into it. The hockey's the easy part.
Well, as he said, the hockey's the easy part. As we just open up the 2002 championship game here, and it looks like first blood has been drawn on the rink, and we'll get to that momentarily. But one of the greatest things I like about State Wars is you can try out, and if you don't make the team, State Wars refunds your tryout fee.
Yeah, you know, we did that a couple years ago. The concept behind that was, you know, we know in youth sports, tryouts are predetermined a lot of times, and people get weary of going to a tryout thinking it's not fair. So our philosophy was, if you don't make it, you get your money back. Come out, give it your all, try out for 2 hours, get to be evaluated by top evaluators, see how you mark up against players your own age in your state, and if you don't make it, you get your money back. So it's a no-lose situation for all the players to come out.
And one of the best things, as Tim said, you get evaluated by top-rate evaluators. When you see somebody from New York like Greg Thompson go to the West Coast and he's evaluating kids that he doesn't see normally during the year, it's fantastic because Greg has an unadulterated opinion. He's able to look at those kids and make decisions with other instructors as well as to who will fit the team and great. Now, one question I have to ask you. This year, every year you change the colors of your uniforms. What really goes into the thought process behind the colors and how do you select that?
Well, it's difficult. We're always trying to think of new colors. You know, some states get bored with the same color, and obviously some states like California have so many different teams, and some states are limited. We take some feedback from parents, players, what they want to see. You know, out here you got the Pennsylvania team this year wearing the old school Phillies colors. and North Carolina wearing the Carolina Panthers colors. So, you know, we try to change around and make it unique each year if we can.
Tim, if I were to look back, this is your seventh year. This has been phenomenally successful. It's so well run. If I were to ask you, and I know this is a very hard question, if you could give me your greatest memory with State Wars, what would it be?
That is a tough question. Obviously, the puck drop in the first time will always be special back in 2005. You can't replace that. But every year, there's new memories. We've gotten better, and the events improved every single year. The competition's gotten better. The level of play has gotten stronger. You know, adding a scholarship program a few years ago, I was very proud of for these high school seniors. Getting the elite division now with a big $10,000 money prize for the best players in the country to participate in. You know, there's so many unique things and things we try to get better every year. Of course, we'll never be perfect. We'll never make everyone happy. But we try our best and we work hard at it.
Absolutely. And when can we expect to see Sydney in a State Wars uniform?
Well, Sydney, my daughter, probably never. I don't foresee her being a hockey player. She's more into painting her nails and getting her hair done already. But we'll see, whatever she wants to do.
Definitely. We've been able to spend a couple minutes with Tim McManus. I hope you'll have some time to help us here with some color commentary during the game as well. We're going to be right back on RollerHockeyTV.net right after these commercial messages. You're watching Roller Hockey TV live from Cincinnati, Ohio, State Wars 2011.
The 2011 Bauer Vapor APXR.
This year, we're really excited to bring some new apparel your way. We have four new shirts coming. We've used 100%.
We are live here as play has started, 2002 AAA Championship. If you've just tuned in with us, ladies and gentlemen, Pennsylvania is wearing the old Philadelphia Phillies colors, and North Carolina is wearing the colors of the NFL Carolina Panthers out here, as Tim McManus had told us. Pennsylvania has jumped out to a 2-0 lead this afternoon on some hard work. And if you've been able to get a glimpse of this Pennsylvania team, there are so many strong players that roster out that squad. That team has been built within out of the Marple Arena, which is in Marple, Pennsylvania. They do a fantastic job. That's the home of the Marple Gladiators. And I'll tell you what, these young kids that are out here today in this Burt Division have come out to play hockey, and boy, have they started on fire. When we take a little look at their roster there, looking at some of the players that are out here with Pennsylvania, we look at the fact that Sammy Lipkin, Frank Jurek, Tristan D'Elia, Nicky Pozzulo, Shane Albert, Christian Hartner, Alex Gatone, Jamie DiDomenico, and the coaching staff of Jamie DiDomenico and Christine DeEllis. Pennsylvania has jumped out to an early 2-0 lead in the championship game here at State Wars. And don't forget North Carolina. We can't count them out. Backed up by Matthew Vecini, Ben Smith, Jackson Mees, Austin Davis, Kevin Krupa, Noah Edge, Daryl Now, Eli Yancey, Jack Kromacek, and the coaching staff of Jay Kromacek and Tim Now. And I wonder if that Ben Smith is the same Ben Smith who's attending BU, I believe, or BC, and was last year in the playoffs, had a phenomenal turnout for the Chicago Blackhawks. So as play continues, Pennsylvania has jumped up to a 2-0 lead, and right now North Carolina has control of the puck along the boards. They're going to move it up, and as they do so, it gets turned over to center and dumped in. Chasing that puck is number 99, Jack Kromatuk. He tries to retrieve it, but now it's picked back up by Pennsylvania. Here comes Pennsylvania on the attack. A 3-on-2. They try to maintain control. Great defensive play by the North Carolina defenseman. Puck squirts in front as they try to go back door. But unfortunately, Frank Jurek couldn't close the door or bury the puck. Great pass by his teammate. Here's North Carolina on an odd man break as they come down the wing. And we look and see Jackson Meek with the puck. Jackson in the corner still battling. He then unfortunately loses possession, but there's Jack Kromahek. He picks up the puck. Now Jack with it, and now the Pennsylvania squad will regroup in their own end and maintain control, and they try to move the puck out to center. It's dumped back in by North Carolina. And number five for Pennsylvania, Frank Jurek, will dump it back in. Puck squirts to center, and North Carolina now is on the attack as Jack, the man, once again picks up the puck, enters the red line, but it's stripped and knocked off his stick and goes deep into the Pennsylvania zone. We've got 5 minutes and 48 seconds left in the first half. Pennsylvania is up to a 2-0 lead over North Carolina. And the puck again moves. Great defensive play by North Carolina as number 66 just stripped the puck off there. And we look at Eli Yancey, and it's a goal by North Carolina. They get on the score sheet here with 5:31 to go in the first half, and it's a 2-1 hockey game. That was a great play as number 99, Jack Kromahek, picked up the puck and wristed it over the goaltender, who was surprised shoulder, to make it a 2-1 hockey game. Face-off at center, North Carolina again with a little bit of momentum as they attack back into the zone. Puck goes in deep this time as number 12, Kevin Krupa, will handle the puck and bring it back to center. Now the puck trickles back in, and once again, here comes number 9. He shoots, he scores for Pennsylvania. Tristan D'Elia will score the goal to make it 3-1 on a backhand move, and he puts it on the far side of the net. So the score right now is Pennsylvania 3, North Carolina 1. And boy, the crowd is loud. But then again, if you come from Pittsburgh Steeler country, that's no surprise because you know how loud people are from Pennsylvania. Boy, do they love their sports teams. And they love the Pennsylvania team playing out here this afternoon. North Carolina now with the puck trying to get control. As they trickle down deep into the zone, number 15 is battling there for North Carolina, doing his best, and we get a whistle and stoppage of play. We're going to take this opportunity to pause for a commercial break. You are watching live from Cincinnati, Ohio, the 2002 birth year State Wars Championships.
Joaquin Chavira is a member of the L.A. Palma Cyclones Pro Team and a member of the U.S. National Hockey Team. Joaquin was diagnosed 6 weeks ago with cancer and is in a battle right now and was unfortunately not able to make this trip. The Walk Strong Foundation was created in an effort to help Joaquin Chavira and his family during these tough times. With the help from everyone in our hockey community, this fight can be won. By purchasing a Walk Strong t-shirt, bracelet, or donation, you can make a difference. For more info, find us on Facebook.com or walkstrong.org. Our goal is to help this player once again return to the sport he loves.
Hi, I'm Garnet Alexander. I'm the developer for Mission Roller Hockey Skates. So one of the things that we wanted to do with this skate is to have a radical different look.
This year, we're really excited to bring some
and we're live back here once again. We're live as we Mike Grant, our director here. There he goes. Mike Grant getting the picture back up. And we're live once again, Cincinnati, Ohio, State Wars 2011. While we were gone, ladies and gentlemen, Pennsylvania has had a two-goal outburst to make the game 5-1. Both times, the Pennsylvania players were picking up a loose puck and scoring to bring themselves each time one goal ahead. It's now 5-1, Pennsylvania. And upon that note, North Carolina has called a timeout. So there's a timeout on the floor. And our score again is North Carolina 5. Pennsylvania 5, North Carolina 1. And our whistle is blown there to take the faceoff to center. And as they do so, both teams will line up. North Carolina taking a little bit of momentum time to regroup and talk to their coach about regrouping their strategy. And you've got to really, at this age group, the 2002, these guys coming out here, it's amazing to see so many kids skate so well and be able to handle the puck. And just a great job by both teams. And North Carolina trying to build, hopefully, and regroup and be able to get an offensive attack going. Puck goes deep once again into the zone. And as I said, North Carolina, after the timeout, regroups, and boy, do they score within 8 seconds to make it a 5-2 game. So number 99, Zach Robinson, makes it a 5-2 game there with his, I believe, second goal of the game for North Carolina and doing a great job. Puck now squirts out as we once again watch the Pennsylvania team try to move it forward. As they do down the boards, they enter into the zone to attack. North Carolina, though, playing some great defense, knocking them back. And we're going to have the first penalty of the game. A minor penalty for a trip is called by today's official. And they'll be taking, looks like, number 18, Clark, is going to go to the penalty box for tripping. This will allow Pennsylvania to go on the power play, their first of the afternoon. And as they take the faceoff, it's won by number 5, David Walsh, who dumps it into the corner. Puck then squirts into the far side. What a pass in the slot. What a save by North Carolina goaltender as he just smothered that puck. Goaltender there a little slow to get up. You think he's feeling the effects because he's faced so many shots early on. He regroups, and as he does so, Justin, and I want to make sure I pronounce his name right, Justin Beluzio is the goaltender for North Carolina, doing a fantastic job this afternoon, doing his best out there against this very tough Pennsylvania team who went through the round-robin session basically giving everybody a run for the money. Here's a pass that's broken up as North Carolina player number 15, Ethan Chipping, stops in to break it up. And now it comes back to Pennsylvania. Here's Pennsylvania on the attack. Here's a shot. And once again, big save by Justin Deluzio as he comes up with the save for his teammates. Line change by North Carolina. We line up in the defensive zone for a faceoff. You look at these kids from Pennsylvania coming out of the Marple Arena, you realize how good they are and what a great program Jamie DiDomingo runs out there and how hard these kids work with their skating and everything else that they do. As I speak and say that, number 10 for North Carolina, Ethan Appoint will break the puck up over the red line. However, he's met by three defenders from the Pennsylvania team, and the puck now goes the opposite way. It's a game of cat and mouse. Both teams getting the puck, neither one holding on to it. Puck now is open and wide. What a pass as he tries to set up his fellow teammate, Frank Jurak. Frank was unable to handle the puck, though, as it bounced last second. And now, once again, we have another puck battle. There's a ready, hits the post. Number 27 for Pennsylvania, Shane Albert, tinked the post, or as we say, tinkle the ivory there, as he took a great wrist shot that the goaltender had no opportunity to even see. Now here's Frank Jurak with a pass cross ice. Great play by the defense of North Carolina. And we have a breakaway. The crowd is on its feet as number 16, Avery Clark, is in. He gets caught on the breakaway, but on the rebound is number 10. He picks it up. And, oh, big save by the goaltender. It looks like Ethan Appoint. And their face-off to the side. North Carolina players a little bit upset that that didn't go in, but what a great effort. He was caught on the breakaway, and then following up to clean up the trash for him was Ethan Appoint, and went in and took the shot. Thought he had a goal, but the referee waved it off, and we have a face-off inside North Carolina's defensive zone. 1 minute, 8 seconds left in the first half. A 5-2 lead for Pennsylvania. Again, if you're just tuning in, ladies and gentlemen, Pennsylvania is wearing the old Philadelphia Phillies colors, North Carolina in the colors of the Carolina Panthers. Here's a puck battle along the boards. Both teams working their way into it. Number nine, Tristan D'Elia, tries to get to the puck. He bumps accidentally into the goaltender, and now the puck's moving forward again as North Carolina is deep in their zone. Number 61 has the puck dropped off his stick, and that's Justin McCormick, who loses possession there. Both teams still battling, and we see the puck once again come back out to a Pennsylvania player who takes a wrist shot and puts it on net. And no surprise, that player, number 99, was Jamie DiDomenico. He just put that shot right on net and let it go. Now, North Carolina has the puck as number two, Eric Carpenter, moves it up the boards. It's a two-on-one for North Carolina as they walk in, try to get the shot off. He shoots. He scores! North Carolina, with 12.4 seconds, has made it a 5-3 hockey game. And what a wrist shot that was, as number 99, Zach Robinson, gets the hat trick, it looks like. That's the third of the game for Robinson as he walked down and roofed the puck over the goaltender's shoulder. 7 seconds left as we wind down our first half, and we just like to let everybody know that we want to thank State Wars Hockey and Tim McManus for having us out here this afternoon to be able to bring you RollerHockeyTV.net. That's the end of our first period with the score. It's Pennsylvania 5, North Carolina 3, the 2002 birth year championship game at the 2011 State Wars. We'll be right back after these commercial messages.
And they stay there, and they say yeah, and they stay there. Cause all I do is win, win, win. And if you going in, put your hands in the air, make them stay there.
Ludacris going in on the verse, cause I've never been defeated and I won't stop now. Keep your hands up, get them in.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, as we were at commercial break there, Pennsylvania has scored now to make it a 6-3 hockey game. Pennsylvania working hard this afternoon and showing everybody just how good that squad is, but I don't count North Carolina out one bit. North Carolina will battle their way and work their way back into this hockey game as the puck is dropped at center. There's a pass is put in front. And saved by the goaltender for Pennsylvania, Christian Hartner. Hartner not facing that many shots this afternoon, but doing a good job in the process. North Carolina now battles along the boards with a Pennsylvania player for the puck. Getting a little physical out here as they're going back and forth. Oh, there's a little elbow up in the air by number three of Pennsylvania. And now a puck squirts free. And oh, an inside out moving. That was a pretty one. Back to the point as they work on their puck control, looking for that open man. Nice pass, cross rink. Here they come again, and broken up by North Carolina, who just clears the zone to give his teammates a break, and they're trying to run to the bench for a line change. Pennsylvania now regroups on their own end, and they will have control as they move it up to the boards. Here breaks number five for Pennsylvania, Frank Jurak. He cuts down the wing. Gets a good shot that hits the goaltender up high. Number 30 for North Carolina is Jason Saluzio, who makes a great save. And boy, he's been tested this afternoon. And Pennsylvania will chase the puck down into their own end and then regroup. Along the boards, we've got a little battle for it as two of the players are going back and forth. And now, once again, Pennsylvania comes out winning that one-on-one battle as they've done most of them this afternoon, and taking the puck. Fans here getting a little excited, and as they do, we get a whistle and a stoppage in play. With 10 minutes and 6 seconds left in the second half, it's Pennsylvania 6 and North Carolina 3. Faceoff is in the defensive zone of North Carolina as they look to get something going here. And they do win the faceoff, and a North Carolina player trying to make some forward progress, but he gets hooked a little bit, slowed down. And now there's a battle that's running as Zach Robinson is chasing for a loose puck. That puck is picked up by number 48 for Pennsylvania, who's Nick Zulio. Nick gets that puck, and he moves it forward. So many different Zulios on this team, I think I'm getting confused. Now, number 9 for Pennsylvania makes a great breakout pass. Tristan D'Elia gets that up, but it's picked off by North Carolina, and swinging after it and moving in those colors, which I really like, the North Carolina team's colors, is number 15. And boy, he still has it. Looks like he's got that puck on a thread. He maintains great control as Ethan Chipping kept the puck and did a little bit of a stick handling exhibition in his own end. Now the puck once again will squirt along the boards with 9 minutes and 7 seconds left in this championship game. Pennsylvania up 6-3. North Carolina with a fancy inside-outside move that's broken up. Oh, a little bump against the boards. Both players are okay, and they just head the other way as both number 48 had a collision from Pennsylvania along with number 18. And now the puck squirts out in front of Pennsylvania's own net. North Carolina player tried to hop on it, but it chops back to center. And here go both teams once again trying to make something happen. Great defensive play by North Carolina defenseman who knocked the puck off of Pennsylvania's stick. We have a trip, and it looks like here number 61 for Pennsylvania, Alex Gattone, is going to go to the penalty box. He's going to get 2 for tripping. So while Gattone goes to the box, this will give North Carolina their first opportunity on the power play this afternoon with 8 minutes and 25 seconds to go here left in the game. Our referees are lining the players up here. State Wars again using the new 1 minute and 30 second penalty rule, which Greg Thompson was telling us a little bit earlier has been very, very successful, not only in reducing the amount of time people are in the box, but they've also seen a significant reduction in the amount of penalties that have been called this during this event. The puck gets dumped in as Philadelphia, and I will say Philadelphia because PA, most of these kids are Philadelphia Flyer fans. I think if I were to say Devils, I'd be shot. But here they go as, once again, they're shorthanded. North Carolina is on the power play as they try to make something happen by moving the puck into the zone. North Carolina unfortunately loses control, and again, this is about those one-on-one little battles that you have to win along the boards. Pennsylvania there with a shot on net, and the goaltender is equal to task, and he's not happy at all with the player who came in after the whistle and gave him a little bump. So goaltender for North Carolina, Justin Silizio, saying, I wasn't happy with that. And he got bumped, and looks like they're going to take the center faceoff or award the faceoff to center as the player came in and knocked the net off after the whistle. So here comes North Carolina once again on the power play. They've got 38 seconds left trying to set up, make something happen, and now they finally get the control they want. Puck goes to the corner. Once again, North Carolina just looking to move it. Unfortunately, a blind pass is made along the boards, and that puck squirts free, and we have a foot race now between North Carolina and Pennsylvania to pick up the puck. As they both go, Pennsylvania number 3, Sammy Lipkin, battling along the boards with number 2, Eric Carpenter, and Lipkin wins that battle. Picks up the loose puck, Sammy Lipkin in all alone, shoots, and just like Sidney Crosby, he makes it look easy. Walks around the goaltender with a 1-2-3 triple deke and just puts the puck into the empty net. So we have a 8-3 hockey game at this point with Pennsylvania in a commanding lead with 6 minutes and 57 seconds left to play. One of the great things that you have to appreciate about both these teams is that not only do the kids continue to work hard, but neither team is getting upset and realizing that, hey, this is a battle You've got to go until the clock buzzes and do the best you can. And as I say that, Pennsylvania adds another goal to make it a 9-3 hockey game. So it looks like Pennsylvania right now will have a very, very commanding lead and definitely stay on top of the game. Faceoff goes to center. Referee will drop the puck. And we have exactly 6 minutes and 32 seconds left to play in a 9-3 Pennsylvania game. Once again, Pennsylvania is deep in their own zone. They're trying to regroup, trying to work on setting up the puck and moving it forward. As they do, they come down the boards. Great board pass here along the side. And Pennsylvania, once again, will break out of their own zone. As they move forward, it goes deep into the end. And North Carolina now will pick up the puck. North Carolina with the puck as they start to move it down the boards. And here they come once again, trying to create an attack. Unfortunately, Pennsylvania is just too tough along the boards, knocks it back in, and the puck will be dumped back behind the goal line. As I speak, it's over the red line and dumped into the corner and picked up by the assistant captain of Pennsylvania, who now grabs it and unfortunately gives it away. What a big save by the goaltender for Pennsylvania, Christian Hartner, who comes up huge after his teammate, Nicky Pizzullo, accidentally gave the puck away. And you just ask yourself now, with 5 minutes and 38 seconds left in the game, North Carolina giving it all they have and really doing the best that they brought to this table. Even though they may fall short, there's still an A-plus for hustle and endurance out here. These kids have not quit. And even though they may be a little outmatched, they're still trying to skate their hearts out and maintain a close game. Pennsylvania deep into the zone with a pass that gets picked up by North Carolina on a 2-on-1. Here comes North Carolina deep into the zone. They have a 2-on-1. Player looks over, makes a pass there just a little bit too deep. As for North Carolina, Zach Robinson there tried to feather his teammate, number 15, Ethan Tripping, and unfortunately, Ethan could not handle that pass. And as we see happen so many times, one scoring opportunity that happens to go down the other end of the rink turns into an actual goal, and Pennsylvania heads out now with a 10-3 lead in this hockey game. It's just not much you can say to the kids except, hey, try your best and leave it all on the floor. But Pennsylvania is out to a 10-3 lead as we take our faceoff. Here they come. Boy, the attack does not stop. They come in again hard. Number 5, shot and another goal. And ladies and gentlemen, our 2002 birth year, 2011 State Wars champion, our team Pennsylvania. The kids are out there jumping up and down, just absolutely happy that they've won, as fans are now running on the floor. It's like being at a Philadelphia Eagles game or a Phillies game. The fans here are absolutely rabid, running to the gate to get on the floor with the kids. And we want to congratulate Pennsylvania, our 2002 State Wars champions. As we take this moment, we're going to pause for a commercial break as Rob Chornamut is going to talk to us about Walk Strong with this infomercial. We'll be right back on the RollerHockeyTV.net network.
For more info, find us on Facebook.com or WalkStrong.org. Our goal is to help this player once again return to the sport he loves. Joaquin Chavira is a member of the LA Palma Cyclones Pro Team and a member of the U.S. National Hockey Team. Joaquin was diagnosed 6 weeks ago with cancer and is in a battle right now and was unfortunately not able to make this trip. The Walk Strong Foundation was created in an effort to help Joaquin Chavira and his family through these tough times. With the help from everyone in our hockey community, this fight can be won. By purchasing a Walk Strong t-shirt, bracelet, or donation, you can make a difference. For more info, find us on Facebook.com or WalkStrong.org. Our goal is to help this player once again return to the sport he loves.
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a huge celebration going on the rink right now. If you have the opportunity to watch, the Pennsylvania team is out there, North Carolina, and they've been joined by Michigan, who is our bronze medal winner, and they'll all be receiving their medal. And congratulations once again to Pennsylvania as we are live right now in the MLRH studios. And taking this opportunity to talk to everybody about October 29th. Major League Roller Hockey has its season opener, which is 2011-2012 season. That night you'll see two great hockey games in action as both the LA Palma Cyclones take on the Arizona Arsenal, immediately followed by the 2011 championship defending champion Mission Axiom taking on the Anaheim Bullfrogs. And don't forget, fans, that 7 o'clock game is a very special evening as number 47, Joe Cook, will have his jersey retired before the Bullfrog game. And we heard Rob Laurie earlier tell us he'll be there to definitely cheer his old teammate on. And then November 6th, MLRH returns to the 949 Roller Hockey Center, as that evening the Anaheim Bullfrogs will once again play, and Rob Laurie will have his jersey retired. Number one will be raised to the rafters that evening. So you've got two great weekends of hockey with Major League Roller Hockey, both October 29th and looking like November 6th. Right now from the RollerHockeyTV.net studios, we're going to take you live to the awards ceremony where Michigan, North Carolina, and the 2002 division champion, Pennsylvania, team from Marple Arena, will be receiving their medals. Let's go live to the rink.
Now for the 2002 AAA gold medalist, Team Pennsylvania. Number three, Sammy Lipkin. Number five, Frank Urach. Number nine, Tristan Diella. Number 18, Nikki Pozzulo. Number 27, Shane Albert. Number 48, Chris Blangle. number 61, Alex Gatone. Number 99, James DiDomenico. And the goaltender, number 30, Christian Hartner. Team Pennsylvania, coached by Jamie DiDomenico, Mike Casey, and John Gatone. Ladies and gentlemen, Team Pennsylvania. And now for the Tour Championship Game Most Valuable Player. This player will be receiving a free pair of Tour hockey skates with 4 goals and 2 assists in the championship game. From Team Pennsylvania, number 27, Shane Albert. At this time, State Warriors would like to present Team Pennsylvania with their championship trophy.
Find us on Facebook.com or walkstrong.org. Our goal is to help this player once again return to the sport he loves. Joaquin Chavira is a member of the LA Palma Cyclones Pro Team and a member of the U.S. National Hockey Team. Joaquin was diagnosed 6 weeks ago with cancer and is in a battle right now and was unfortunately not able to make this trip. The Walk Strong Foundation was created in an effort to help Joaquin Chavira and his family during these tough times. With the help from everyone in our hockey community, this fight can be won. By purchasing a Walk Strong t-shirt, bracelet, or donation, you can make a difference. For more info, find us on Facebook.com or walkstrong.org. Our goal is to help this player once again return to the sport he loves.